scream, rough vocals, but the, and then 1,000 Apologies is the more obvious one, and only like
Scout, hush,
and only one bit of it is rough vocals. So
what's the name of the other one?
What other one?
You said there was a...
Oh yeah, and then there's that one that you had suggested some time ago.
Yeah, and I've been kind of waiting till Trey can do it with mm-hmm. us, but...
And that's still an option. Yeah, and then that one I'm still unsure about because lyrics, but... Because I don't know. It's kind of confusing. That's another one that I definitely couldn't tell you what the heck it's talking about. Yeah, and then these are the two Demon Hunter ones. No, it isn't. This one's Demon Hunter and Dream Theater, I guess. Let me make sure here. This one doesn't. This one's missing 1,000 Apologies. Maybe that's one of the ones that you have. I guess not.
1,000 Apologies.
Okay, yeah, it is. For whatever reason, I was expecting it to be in here.
Okay, yeah, that's 1,000 Apologies.
Yeah. Is it just one sheet of it?
No, there's
one. Oh, okay. I mean, it can be wherever it wants. I just expected it to be in here because
narrow it's down to two.
Of the three or four?
Yes.
Or,
I mean, two out of these four. I'm helping you out here.
Again, I'm iffy on ever doing that one, because...
Okay, so we knock these two out, because I do really want Trey to be here when we do Still and Lost.
So it's, I mean, it's still, yeah, I mean...
Okay. Adrian.
Yeah?
You get to pick. Okay. Part That's Holding On by Red or 1,000 Apologies by Demon Hunter?
You said... Heart That's Holding On?
Part That's Heart, Holding
yeah.
On.
Okay.
Yeah, Part That's Holding On by Red.
Or 1,000 Apologies?
By Demon.
Hey, Ron. Oops. If you want to trudge that one up, there's a white one. Like, if there's a white one, you can trudge up.
Oh.
Rather than those.
Mm-hmm. They're both fairly
yeah.
clear on...
I prefer you to trudge the white one.
I say that.
Just because it's hard on those posts.
Okay, sounds good.
Thank you.
Right there.
Oh,
what?
He's both sad.
what are you?
They're all sad.
Yes, they are.
Man.
Happy songs are boring.
Happy songs are boring.
There's a song by Phil Collins called Happy. I think. I'll find that.
I don't know.
I guess,
what about Mercy? Me, shake.
To me, there's shake, less to talk about. Less. So I don't need that.
Correct.
But eventually we do need to do that one from Tarzan.
From what?
Tarzan.
The one that...
No.
What song about Tarzan?
Son of Man.
The one that's called Son of Man, I guess? It's
called Son of Man.
I don't know. What's the...
It's in same Tarzan.
Person? Oh, yeah. I don't think I've seen the animated Tarzan recent one.
Okay.
Phil.
The recent one?
Well,
no. It's like 90-year-old one.
Oh. I'm used to the one that's like from the 70s.
Yeah, it'd be that one, probably.
Make It Real, Man.
It's probably that one.
Oh,
I don't know. I don't know.
I don't think they sang in that movie. In the original.
Oh, it is. The song is by Phil Collins.
Oh, I like Phil Collins.
Yeah.
Here.
Hold on. I mean,
and
whatever.
Apparently it's stuck. And every word sounds like Sutton Shua. Literally, every single word.
Not every word, but a lot of it.
These.
Thank you.
Yes, buddy.
This is my favorite part. I still say it's not about Jesus. I say it's just about...
You can tweak it for Jesus.
I say it's about believers.
It doesn't need tweaking. It's about
it just, it's
I like it about believers.
I sound about... to me, it sounds like it's about people. But
I think you're right. Well, it's a Tarzan movie. Maybe it was about Tarzan.
I think you're all right.
Well, we've listened to the song. Well, let's pull up the lyrics and do that one.
Oh, I wasn't... Sorry. I wasn't meaning it like...
Tonight? No, I'm not. I'm not fussing. I'm just saying, well, we already listened to a song. Let's do it. But yeah, we have to pull up the lyrics on our phones because we don't have printouts. Okay, so it's called Son of Man by Phil Collins.
Phil Collins?
Do you want to set up your phone to do the Facebook live thing?
No.
Oh, I'll put Son of Son. That doesn't work. Son of Man.
He needs it for lyrics, though.
Phil Collins, he can look off you.
Off what?
Off you.
Me? I wasn't going to pull you up.
Then pull it up on your other hand at the end.
No.
You big goon. Oh, it's this has, were you looking at the actual clip? Like the video? Because this has the video. The actual clip of it.
Yeah,
little Tarzan baby voice.
Yeah, it's like a little montage and he's like going from
coming of age.
Sorry, he's a kid, and then at the end he's a man.
It's the coming of age song. Yeah.
But I can see the same thing now, Yeshua. And it really works.
Oh.
I don't think so.
Oh, well, let's figure it out, dadgummit. Let's see. Oh, the power to be strong and the wisdom to be wise, all these things will come to you in time. On this journey that you're making, there will be answers that you'll seek, and it's you who will climb the mountain, it's you who will reach the peak. Son of man, look to the sky, let your spirit set it free. Someday you'll walk tall with pride, son of man, a man in time you'll be.
You'll walk tall with pride.
So there's no one there to guide you, no one to take your hand, but with faith and understanding, you will journey from boy to man. Son of man, look to the sky, lift your spirit, set it free. Someday you'll walk tall with pride. Son of man, a man in time you'll be. In learning you will teach, in teaching you will learn. You'll find your place beside the ones you love. Oh, and all the things you've dreamed of, the visions that you saw, well, the time is drawing near now. It's yours to claim it all. I think it says
in
all, not in all. Claim in all.
Claim in all, yeah.
That didn't make any sense. But anyway, son of man, look to the sky. Lift your spirit, set it free. Someday you'll walk tall with pride. Son of man, a man in time you'll be. Son of man, son of man's.
Ooh,
a man for all to see. Yeah, that's kind of a kicker right there.
There's something
you could make that plug. Yeah. So Phil Collins was either getting away with a big one.
Mm-hmm. He pulled a fast one on Disney.
Pulled a fast one on Disney.
I think.
Mm-hmm.
He's Christian. I don't know if he is, but Ron probably know.
Walt Disney Music Company. I don't know. Well, Phil Collins. Yeah, he probably won't say, yo, he's a Christian.
Not unless you're Wikipedia.
He's a drummer, it says.
Well, yeah.
Well, yeah. Because
I assume that everybody is.
I believe he started as a drummer, and then he became the lead singer. And not behind the drums.
Lead singer for who? Not for who?
Genesis.
Brian?
The name of his band was Genesis.
I thought you said Francis.
I was right. I was
right. It can still just mean Christian. It doesn't mean it's about Yeshua.
Well, are you saying that he's Christian just because you did a band called Genesis?
Yeah. Genesis could be anything.
Not necessarily.
Well, it wasn't just Genesis and the band. You have to look at all the members of the band, too.
Yeah. There's hints.
It could still mean just Christians and believers.
Or it could mean absolutely anybody. It's a coming-of-age song. You know, father to son.
But there's things in here that
exactly what it portrays in the montage.
Okay. Well, okay.
Maybe it's like maybe I'm too boring, but
So in the context of Tarzan, or there's things that don't make sense. So for
he lives amongst a bunch of apes.
Well, yeah.
Yes. No. That's a point in favor, but
humanity acting like a bunch of savages, maybe.
But
the Tarzan movie is 1999.
Yeah, but for the case that the song means Yeshua, a few things that stand out. Let's see here. In learning you will teach, and teaching you will learn.
Mm-hmm.
That brings to mind when he was in the temple, when he was teaching the
rabbis
and all that.
Mm-hmm.
Well, in teaching, he's learning, he's doing it, he's practicing it.
In fact, one of the Hebrew words is used for learning. Just the same.
However, on the flip side of that, as Christians, the more we teach the Bible, the more we learn it.
Yeah. Or as human beings.
Shut up, Cal!
we're devolving here. Like, Yeshua. Yeah. Christians.
Anybody.
Dogs.
Yeah.
Are you eating cookie dough? I like cookie dough, raw or cooked, but no.
I'm pretty sure once you cook it, it's not dough anymore.
I can just give you a small piece. It's homemade.
With or without egg.
I can do it.
I just give you a small piece.
And then,
I don't mean to have to give you like a hunk.
So are you going to talk about this song?
Well, I think they're in the process.
We are.
It's just
okay. What other? Make your argument, Adrian.
Okay. There's the learning you will teach and teaching.
I'll fight you.
Sounds none of that. And teaching you will learn. So raise mind the temple when he was teaching the rabbis,
mm-hmm.
and his human form was learning, in the process, right?
Mm-hmm.
But his spirit
was teaching.
The God, was teaching,
mm-hmm.
right?
Are we recording?
While he was there.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And it says you'll find your place.
You'll find a place beside the ones you love. Okay, two parts there,
mm-hmm.
two cases. You'll find a place beside the ones you love. Where did he end up? On the cross, beside people that he loved.
That's reaching.
that's reaching. That one's reaching.
And,
but yeah, counselor.
And I'm not finished. Don't shut me down. Don't you.
I'll shut y'all down.
Silence. And ultimately, where will we end up? Beside him in heaven.
Like Christian.
He's going to make a place for us beside him. Right.
That's probably a better argument than the.
Find a place beside the ones you love. And all the things that you've dreamed and the visions that you saw, right? Each dreamer of dreams and visions.
Right.
Okay, which he did. He did. The time is drawing near now. It's yours to claim it all. What is he claiming?
His dream.
His
dream. His dream.
The kingdom. Us. The time is drawing near now. Okay, it's time to, you know, do. Right. He's getting ready to go, you know, do his thing right across.
And do his thing.
Yes. And it just freaked out here.
My turn. Okay. Oh, he's done.
Look to me as the like very last son of man, son of man's a man for all to see. I mean, that's like.
That too.
That could just scream Jesus.
It does. It very much does.
There was something else earlier than that, though. That.
Oh, the power to be strong and the wisdom to be wise. Mm-hmm. All these things will come to you in time. Right. not necessarily about Yeshua, but it does sound like him, does it not?
Yeah. I'm gonna tell you.
It's the one who will climb the mountain.
Mm-hmm.
Right. Like Moshe. Right?
Not Jesus though.
He comes in the steps of Moshe.
Not Jesus though.
And see who will reach the peak. Right.
Oh, I was thinking going off over
the carrying the cross, yeah.
Yeah.
Well, I'm not a watch, but
I rest my case.
More, I think out the case.
More may be said in my favor if.
I think Phil Collins was pulling a woolly on Disney.
See?
Yeah.
Cheers.
Okay.
He got away with writing a song for Tarzan that could just as well. Because there always has to be an archetypal hero.
Tarzan is a Jesus figure.
Tarzan is a Jesus figure.
He is.
Tarzan doctors.
Okay.
Can I? Sure. I have to argue. I think it's Christian or very Jesus-like. However, I don't think it's Jesus. I don't think it's specifically about Yeshua. I say it's about Christians or followers, believers in God and in Jesus. For these reasons.
Okay. Yeah.
Okay. The power to be strong and the wisdom to be wise. All of these things will come to you in time. So that means it's going to take a journey. It's going to take you discerning over time and learning these things.
You don't think Jesus did that? I think he had to do that.
Yeah, but he's also Jesus. Like, he's...
Well, you know, see, you can't argue against a generalization by saying, oh, but a subset of that generalization is true, right? That I agree with? You can't argue with the generalization like that.
Like, Jesus, yes, but he's Jesus. Like, he's God. In man's body.
Walking as a man. Yeah.
Walking as a man.
With the powers of a man, not of God.
Yeah.
Well, you say that.
Philippians 2.
He multiplied fish and loaves.
But we're supposed to be able to do that too. He said that if we had the faith of a mustard seed, we could move mountains too.
Lord, help us if most people could turn water into wine.
Woo! Yeah. What are you going to say, Roland?
I'll be last. Tell me.
Oh, okay.
Are you or you're not done?
I'm not done.
No. She had the first, you know, stanza.
Yeah. Okay. So, on this journey, there'll be answers that you seek. So, what do we do as baby Christians? We ask questions. We learn more. It's a journey. We're not quite there yet. And then, son of man, actually, the son, like, of men, not Jesus, son of man. It's like, son of man. Look to the sky. What do? As believers, we look for God.
Or that could mean when he saw the dove after he got baptized and he looked up and God said, well done, my good and faithful servant.
Yeah.
Look to the sky.
No.
see the flutterby?
The flutterby. And then it says, lift your spirit, set it free. Okay. All right. Now, we come to the one lyric that you and I differ on. I will admit, I thought it said, someday you won't toy with pride.
Oh, my.
Which is why I was like,
with pride, yeah.
Well, that's why I was like, well, it can't be Yeshua, because, you know, he was not really a very, like, prideful person. He was rather, like, humble, and he's like, don't, like, you know what I mean? Like, yes, I did this, but, like, don't be, like,
it advertising.
Was, yeah, like, it was God, and I am just doing his will on earth.
I still love the fact it's like, I didn't do it, God did. Which is me. No.
Yeah. But still.
Even if you're just a Christian, it's God doing it through you. He wouldn't have done it through you if you hadn't said,
yeah,
but in Jesus'
let me do
case,
that for you.
So here's
my thing.
Someday you'll walk tall with pride. I don't know. That's pride. I don't know.
Well, there is a...
There's a good pride.
There's a good pride.
There's very healthy pride.
Well, walking tall with pride can mean he's confident. He's...
Right.
Sure, he's sure of himself because he knows his purpose. At some point along the line, I think that perhaps his human brain didn't know what his purpose was. And then, specifically...
I'm sure at 2 years old, he couldn't cognitively make sense of the fact that he was the Son of God.
And then
he
at some
had
point
to
during
learn
his life, God was like, okay,
yes, but he never sinned.
On you, that
his parents
exactly
had to share that with him at some point.
Right, but he never sinned. He never had human pride.
Right.
It was righteous
the bad time. Yeah.
And righteous anger. He never sinned. He was sinless.
Right.
So that's where I say with pride that that's a very, very fine line. And while men will fall in pride, like Jesus did not. That's why I think with the pride line,
mm-hmm.
it differs.
There's a good pride, though.
But
yeah.
Yes.
Walking tall with pride. Yes, that's the good kind.
But then there's no one there to guide you, no one to take your hand, but with faith and understanding, you'll journey from boy to man. God was guiding Jesus. So, not Jesus.
Well, there was no one like him on earth, though. There was no one to bring him up to say...
Stop being smart!
Hey, there's no one on earth to be like... Because Mary couldn't, Joseph couldn't.
Yeah, nobody could tell him how to be the son.
No one could tell him what to... How to grow up as a perfect kid. With... Indwelling, you know, God indwelling him more so than everyone else, right? There was no one like him on the planet who could advise him besides the Heavenly Father. So.
Anyways, moving on.
You're right, but shh.
And learning you will teach, and in teaching you will learn. So yes, Jesus did do that. But.
We all do that too.
We all do that too.
I get you on that one.
And it says, you'll find your place beside the ones you love. So, like, you love Jesus, and you love God, and you love all his people, right? And so by being a faithful follower, you're going to earn your place besides all the ones you love.
That's
okay.
True.
Hold on. I have a crap. That was my spot.
Well, okay, hold on.
Nope.
I'm too excited. But do you earn it?
Oh, it says you'll find. I'm sorry.
Okay, fine.
You'll find.
I see.
And then all the things you dreamed of, the visions that you saw, the time is drawing near, right? It's time yours to claim it all. Okay, that's being like, yo, the time is coming. Claim your spot in heaven by repenting and being like, okay, I am a sin-filled person. Do it now because the time is coming and you ain't gonna, you're not gonna have your spot besides all the ones you love. If you don't do it now, claim it now, claim your inheritance.
Salvation is not preached unless the black ponytail goes, woo, watch out!
Yeah.
Claim it now!
Wait, can I do that?
Yeah, a little bit.
Okay, whoa.
So, and then finally, son of man's a man for all to see. So, what do we call?
I'm not a man.
I'm gonna say, thank you.
I know you.
Yeah.
I know where you're going.
What is a man?
Why?
A man is a boy who's gone through all the trials of life and grown up and become, a believer in Jesus Christ of the Lord above.
Jesus Christ,
Lord above.
That was a Southern Baptist claim for a man for good measure. She's working it.
Jesus Christ, Lord above. And a man is not a boy. It's not a baby Jesus
right.
Or a baby believer.
Baby.
Baby. It is a man.
You guys are killing me.
And
What does a true believing man do? He shows that he is a true believing man for all to see. It is about Christians, not just baby Jesus. Or the Jesus.
not being a Jesus?
Not baby Jesus. Not baby Jesus.
Well, exactly. You said he's not a man, so.
He's God.
Of course, the song's all about baby Jesus, because he's not a man.
He incarnates a man. God. Well, God's kind of a man. Kind of. Not really.
Not really.
God is not a person.
He's an entity. An all-knowing, omnipresent.
Okay, omniscient. Who gets to throw out their arguments next? Cal. Yeah, Cal for just basic humanity.
Well, it's just an optimistic coming-of-age story. I mean, it's literally just, you know, if you do everything right will happen.
But if you're doing everything right, where does your morality come from?
If you're doing everything right, you're Jesus.
Well, you know, that's a lovely question, isn't it?
You're doing everything right. Why are you doing everything right? Where do your morals come from?
Because you're Jesus.
Isn't that a good question?
No, because you're a Jesus follower.
We don't do everything right. We can't.
Okay, Tal's turn to argue.
If we could answer the source of morality, then, like, you know, boy, would that solve a lot of problems.
A lot of issues. Yes.
So, you know, I just don't see how you would get it more specific. It's a coming of age. I mean, that's all it is. I don't know. I don't have fancy points or whatever, because to me, it's just obvious to me.
if you watch that, was that song written for the movie?
Yes,
probably.
Sure. Yeah. Phil Collins wrote all these songs.
Can't imagine.
Okay. He has slower ones.
Album Tarzan. Okay. Yeah. So.
Hold on.
All right. Ron.
Don't squash my spirit.
Oh, no. I'm actually...
Don't crush it.
No, y'all are saying more or less the same thing, and I agree with everybody here.
That's a cop-out.
No, I'll give you scripture. I'm about to give you scripture.
Uh-oh.
In Exodus chapter 4, Israel is called the son of God. Okay? Read it for yourself. Israel is the son of God, according to... And actually, the first time that phraseology is mentioned in the Bible. And it's just assumed that Adam is the son of God. Don't say that until the New Testament. In Luke, in fact. But and then Israel's also the son of man. All of these things are applied to humans way back when. Okay, so we're all right about that, including Tao. And so, okay. So son of man can be a messianic title. Can be a title for son of God, can be a messianic title as well. Son of God can mean son directly of God as well. You know, the way John uses it in particular. Depends on who's talking. And so the Bible agrees with all of us here. All right?
He's being diplomatic.
No, I'm not being diplomatic. I'm being doggone biblical. Which is, yes, diplomatic.
Well, that'll send you to hell.
Well, here's the point I'm trying to make.
How dare you be right?
Well, see, I love the implications, like being biblical will send you to hell.
I mean, hey, Adam and Eve fell because they ate the one tree God said don't eat from. Not just yet. Read the rest of the Bible about that. And in a world full of trees, you know, the world that they knew anyway. They chose the one that God said no.
One could say a jungle.
Yeah.
We all know it's a garden.
Two, because they did that, their first act of anything was in the wrong direction, i.e. immoral. And so they didn't show up for the Sabbath either. The first Sabbath, they missed. God is alone there. Not the, you know, I mean, he doesn't say to Adam, it's not good for a man to be alone. He is saying it to himself. He did not say anything to Adam at that point. Read it closely. And, you know, so, I mean, the Lord is very much relating to us so that we can relate to him. That's what I'm trying to say here. And he wants to become like us because he made us to be like him. You know, we don't realize who we are were made in the image and as the likeness of who? Of God. And as we grow, because we lost a redemption, is this, you know, 1 Corinthians chapter 3. We grow from glory to glory in the Spirit back into his image. Now let me read something to you, because the word for image is translated form also. Let your attitude toward one another be governed by your being in union with the Messiah Yeshua. Though he was in the form of God, though he was in the image of God, though he was a, you know, he was in the image of God just like we're in the image of God. What does that mean? This is before it says he, you know, he laid all that down. This is before he, that says he laid all that down. And it'll tell us later on in this verse who he is in this particular piece. This is before he came to earth. He's in the image of God. What does it mean to be in the image of God? Okay? I mean, I don't, we're not a dog. We're not a cat. We're not a mule. We're not a hippopotamus. We're humans. And humans are extraordinarily special. Extremely special. We make watches. We make computers. Solomon, it says a couple of times, made devices. And, you know, all of this, it's been going on for a long time. We didn't develop. We're humans. Okay? We're humans. It's huge. Mammoth. We don't know who we are. Okay, so, being in the image of God, in the form of God, form, image, whatever. You know, translate, we want to separate. Though he was in the form of God, he did not regard equality with God something to be possessed by force, because he was already there. On the contrary, he emptied himself in that he took on the form of a slave, image of a slave, by becoming like human beings are, in just the state that we are in since the fall, particularly. And when he appeared as a human being, he humbled himself still more by becoming, and this is the attitude, let your attitude toward one another be like this. He humbled himself still more by becoming obedient even to death, death on the stake as a criminal. Therefore, God raised him to the highest place and gave him the name above every name, that in the honor of the name given Yeshua, every knee will bow. And this is a quote out of Isaiah. Every knee will bow, every tongue will confess to me that I am God. And he used the word God, Elohim, there. That in the name given to Yeshua, every knee will bow in heaven and on earth and under earth, every tongue will acknowledge that Yeshua the Messiah is Adonai, is Yod-Heh-Vav-Heh. To the glory of God the Father. And this is one of the probably three or four places in the New Testament where we would call it technical. Every verse is technical to me. But this is one of those verses that says that God is the Father, Yeshua is Yod-Heh-Vav-Heh. John, God is the Father, Yeshua is Yod-Heh-Vav-Heh. 1 Corinthians 9, Yeshua is Yod-Heh-Vav-Heh, Father is God. But then you go to the New Testament, or the Old Testament, pardon me, and you'll read plenty of times where Yod-Heh-Vav-Heh is the same as God. So, you know, I was just listening to a song today that said, one plus one plus one. Right. Echad. Echad does not mean one plus one plus one. Echad means a unit. So, you know, he is Echad. So, you know, I'm just saying, he is God, and he's always been that, therefore. But he laid himself down. He was in the image of God prior to laying himself down. So he is Son of God, Son of Man, as he is God and man, because that's who we are. We don't realize it. We don't. I'm not saying we're God. I'm saying we're made in the image of God. We're made to be a whole lot like him. So if mankind in general is made to be a whole lot like God, that song is talking to mankind. God has really huge hopes for mankind, whom he made to have a very special relationship with himself. And part of that is bringing us to him in redemption, hence we're Christians. And therefore, that's when we take on this ability to grow. Mankind in general would love to grow spiritually and psychologically. But they can only grow physically and partly psychologically. Their spirit is dead. Yes, he wants us to become and grow back into his image, to be very much like him, Adrian. very much like Yeshua, who is Yod-Heh-Vav-Heh. So I agree from the Bible with everybody here, even from Philippians chapter 2 and a few small verses. But that's the attitude that we are to have toward one another, to see the spark of divinity in one another. It's a growing thing, just as humans are meant to grow. Yes, how much more believers are meant to grow and be just like him together. There, that's my sermon.
Just like if it is about Jesus, it's only insofar as we're supposed, as Jesus, you know, acting as the example of what everybody should be. So yeah.
And yeah, that's what it means to be sinless. He was, if sin, according to the Bible, 1 John chapter 4, is that which is Torah-less, same as being outside of Torah. I don't have Torah. Then being sinless is to be completely Torah observant with no mistakes along the way. That's why I say he's the most Jewish man who's ever lived. Mm-hmm. It's basically what you're saying there. So, no, we're not going to be just like that. But we can grow and become, you know, sinless, as in we sin less as we grow. And again, sin is defined by Torah and not by our whims or churchianity. Churchianity doesn't know what it's talking about when it comes to, we're just riding over here talking about arguments that I heard when, 50 years ago about whether or not you should dance. Well, what kind of argument is that, you know? That's churchianity, strictly speaking. The Bible has nothing to say, but all it says is
thinking of the wrong sort of dancing.
Yeah, it's like the only way we can think of dancing is the screwed up dancing that the world does. We don't ever read the Bible.
Well, and I'm a proponent of dancing because David danced.
Yes, he did.
In fact, he danced half naked. But
yeah.
Anyway.
I'm not going to dance half naked.
Yeah, you're not going to go that far?
Right.
I'm not going to dance half naked, but I can't dance half naked because I'm a woman.
Yeah.
So.
And there's.
Depends on which half, I suppose.
And you know there's dancing.
No, we can't dance half naked anyway.
But
well, no, if you like
I'll do the right half.
Well, no, it's like, you know, say, you know, most of your legs, your arms, I mean, your back, I mean, you can uncover a lot more than half.
I don't want to be modest.
What I'm saying in that is that,
well,
we,
sorry, I didn't realize we were adding that criteria.
Oh, yeah, no.
That's kind of a big one right there.
And I'm not going to cause other people to stumble.
What I'm saying in that is we don't necessarily read the whole Bible particularly.
No husband would ever be satisfied with their own wife that came after Kelsey.
Wait, what? Well, that's not what I meant. Like,
I'm a homodist.
That's not what I meant. I meant like people who don't have wives. Gotcha.
People who don't have wives don't have wives.
Mm-hmm. No. That's so mean.
I'm just kidding. I was just... I thought maybe that's
not true. I don't mind.
On the churchianity jump, I'm sorry about that. I just, yeah, that you could edit that.
No.
Churchianity, hobbits, you know, details.
Huh? Yeah. Oh. You gotta quit blurting that out without like prepping people for
that
it.
Just
most
likes
people haven't
all of a sudden.
Yeah.
Don't live with you, so they don't know where that train of thought comes
from. My mind.
Wait, Hobbit?
He is saying like churchianity, which is only a form but denying the power, is like living in the Shire. They don't want to get out. Adventure is a no-no. They want everything to stay calm and quiet.
Well, have second breakfast.
Never go.
They can eat a whole lot, but they can't
the
go actually.
Before Gandalf came along, the Bagginses were very well respected. Never went on any adventures or did anything unexpected.
There you go. Very.
In fact, they live in a pit in the side of the hill. That's called the Lord digging you out of the really, really horrible, awful pit called yourself. But all you're accustomed to is pits. That's all you know. So you'll dig another pit. And it's a really, really clean pit. Oh,
so instead of fighting orcs and dragons, they fuss about party invitations. Like
and neighbors coming to steal their silverware.
Yeah. So once you realize that there is a larger world afoot and it is actually a battle, and you get outside the Shire,
you discover reality.
You discover God in a bigger,
more real way.
Badass way. Okay.
This weekend we're totally having a Lord of the Rings marathon.
We can't this weekend. Oh. Yeah. We have graduation and
maybe
a wedding.
This weekend.
Okay, never mind.
Who's graduating?
Mallory.
Oh boy, she's like having an eventful week, huh? Birthday, graduation.
Car
stolen.
And besides, if you're gonna have a Lord of the Rings marathon, then I need to be there.
We can't do it next week because we have
so much going on this week.
Yeah.
So, rather have this weekend.
What is the Saturday?
And plus, I have all.
You guys are gonna be gone after this,
anyways,
right?
Everyone doing St. Louis. We're sitting regulars.
Week.
Okay.
Oh, it's only 3 hours.
That's
come on. Where's the 5 hour ones?
Okay.
There aren't any 5 hour ones.
Thought.
Yeah. I think the longest.
Do you guys have New Year's Day off work?
Oh, you get to.
New Year's Day off? Yes, I do.
So, New Year's Eve is our anniversary, but we like to spend it with, like, you guys.
I'm house sitting that night, but
are you guys?
You guys are more than welcome to come hang out with me at the house.
Mm.
I'm allowed to have people over.
Cool.
Party!
Because you could kind of cross a Lord of the Rings marathon with New Year's Eve party.
No.
Because you can stay up late. You don't have to go home, you know, and get up real early the next morning.
True.
He has to go home. I don't have to go home.
Well.
Okay, fair.
Yeah. You know what I mean. But, you know, that's a thought. We can talk about it later. Okay. Any other thoughts on that song?
What are your thoughts? Since you were the one who didn't present a position, you can be the judge.
Oh, I was helping you out.
Okay.
I could do the whole like I said while you were doing your argument, there are many stories told with the archetypal, you know, hero / ideal that whether we like to acknowledge it or not, all strive for. Sometimes we don't acknowledge that there are ideals or morals, however you want to name them.
Hopefully everybody admits that there are ideals.
In
some form or another.
Yeah. I don't know if everybody does. I'm kind of clueless on that point. But I'm biased because I always tend to... We've been tweaking songs for Jesus, you know, for years. And so, I mean, literally, we would take songs and that were, you know, written, doesn't matter if it's by a secular artist, a Christian artist, or whatever.
We got a little out of hand there for a bit.
Yeah, we got a little crazy there for a bit. But it's almost, the way we always thought of it was God created music. The adversary will pervert music. So... Let's take what the devil stole and yank it back. And so some lyrics, whether they know it's coming out of them or not, God can use them to write principles that he wants them to see on paper and then have to sing a million times over if it gets popular. And so words work into people. And so I look at lyrics and the first thing I see is, if it is possible to see in a song, is Jesus, you know, or God working something out in some way. And I think, you know, shucks, that's part of Hanukkah. We're supposed to be looking for the light. We're supposed to be looking for it wherever we can find him. And... acknowledge it when you find it. And that particular song has a lot of light in it. It has a picture painted that looks like Jesus. And if we're following Jesus, it's going to look like us. And sometimes the world, even unconsciously, can act actually a lot more like Jesus than we do, which is kind of sad to say. But yeah, so, but primarily, I wasn't thinking it at first because I'm like, it's about Tarzan, come on. It's not even about all this other crap. You know, it's about Tarzan because it's written for the movie. But if you think about it, if you think about, I don't know how much you know about Phil Collins, but he's a very thinking person. You know, he didn't write stupid, repetitive, shallow, I would call it, music. He kind of wrote intellectually. And so, and obviously being a drummer, which kind of always seemed to me like you kind of have to be part of a mathematician to do drums. But yeah, so I'm sure he layered it with a whole lot of stuff that common bear might not catch.
Sprinkle Jesus.
Yeah, or sprinkle the ideal, you know, the archetype. Jordan Peterson talks about the Pinocchio all the time. There's an archetype in Pinocchio, it's a father figure. So there are lots of stories like that. So I'm not surprised that this one acts like it too. I still saw all the apes. Y'all are talking about, you know, Jesus in the middle of all this, and I'm thinking, what about all the apes?
Theoretically, most movies, your protagonist is going to be an archetypal something.
Yeah. Unless it's Deadpool.
Are you sure?
Well, I guess he's an archetypal something, but not something you should emulate.
The archetypal fool?
Yeah. Archetypal idiot.
No.
But it's funny.
Just to make a very small comment on Phil Collins, not that I've ever met Phil Collins. Mm.
Just kidding.
Well, he's raised in London, so he's probably, you know, before London was taken over by Islam, and so he probably had at least semi-Christian upbringing. And so I'm trying to say he's not.
Maybe
he
was banned as Jameson.
You know,
which can mean, which is a Latin word. No.
Meaning?
Beginning.
Yeah. It's like,
but, can refer to a lot more than a book in the Bible.
Yeah.
But I don't know if it was he that named the band, but, you know, he's been married 3 times and all that sort of thing, but the reason why we separate secular Christians is because of record labels. There's lots of quote-unquote secular musicians who are Christians and lots of quote-unquote Christian singers who are not very Christian, but they're sing for particular labels, and so we call them that. But Phil Collins, you know, he's a good person and all that sort of thing. So when he wrote those songs for a movie, he was probably just following the movie line. But, you know, I don't necessarily put him in the quote-unquote secular column just because I never met the guy. But that's all I'll say about Mr. Collins. I think we sometimes cookie-cut things a little bit too tightly, and I just never met the guy.
If you're gonna have all your dough, you have to cook it
tightly. Baking to cookie dough.
Baking lesson number one. If you're gonna cookie cut, you wanna cookie cut really tightly so that you can use as much as your dough as possible.
Oh.
Obviously.
He said we cookie cut too tightly sometimes. Well, you use all your dough.
Well, I mean, you know.
No, I
conform to the cut.
As far as life goes. There are some things to cookie cut.
Just telling the joke. I was being funny.
I love
it. It didn't work.
I nearly laughed.
I nearly laughed.
He said it.
Ron is the one that needs smacked there. I'll give it to him.
Be supportive. Wife.
That was a full blown snicker. I heard it.
I'm afraid of what that means.
Yeah, I do.
You better.
Oh. You gonna make it Friday night? This Friday evening? Because I know you guys were gonna miss it.
That's next Friday. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Oh,
We're going outside next week.
Yeah, I think we talked about that when we first decided on the 20th.
Because isn't that why? I mean, we've been working on these songs.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Baptism, and I thought, oh, wait a minute.
It's like, wait, is he going to be there?
Yeah.
Not the songs like Phil Collins songs and stuff.
What?
Yeah, you're going to have to chop some stuff out later.
Sportive.
Sportive.
That's
awesome. That's great.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Any other thoughts? Nope.
No.
No thoughts?
She gets it.
Yay.
This little isn't mine.
You're not funny. Alright, well, I don't have anything else.
Nope.
Go listen
Make
to
good
this
choices.
One. Make good choices.
Do the right thing.
Laugh hard. That
laugh
kind of
good.
Stuff.
We're encouraged to laugh in the Bible.
Dance.
And
well, not like not completely.
Happy Hanukkah / Christmas, because starting Sunday, we are going
Merry
to be
Christmas
delivering gifts and letters to 72 individuals.
That number increased since the last
30
time you
families,
said that?
Mm-hmm. Probably, because it happened just this, like, it got bigger over the past week.
You
we had to put
a cap
on it. No, we had to put a cap on it. I thought 70 was going to, you know, it's like, okay, stop. But then we figured out a way to, some of us will not take gifts or have gifts, and we're giving them to other people. So. So we've kind of juggled it a little bit so that the people who need gifts and letters can have them. But anyway, that will be 22nd through the evening of the 29th, even though Hanukkah goes through the evening of the 30th. But yeah, so we won't be here next Wednesday night or next Friday night. Or baptizing somebody this Friday night, so that'll be cool. Yeah, that's it. So, happy Christmas.